Students, welcome to grade 10th statistics part 3. In our last video, we learnt about mode. Let us revise it quickly. Mode is equal to L plus F1 minus F0 upon 2F1 minus F0 minus F2 into H, where L is the lower limit of the model class, H is the class size, F1 is the frequency of the model class, F0 is the frequency of the class preceding the model class, F2 is the frequency of the class succeeding the model class. How we used to find the model class? When the intervals were given, we used to choose that interval in which the frequency was maximum. Today we will learn some applications of this formula. If mode of the data is 36, find the missing frequency x. The chart is given here. Cumulative frequencies are given in the form of intervals and frequencies are given like this. One of the frequencies is missing. Now here we have to first of all find out the model class. Why? Because mode of the data is given. So model class, how will we find? We will see which is where does this mode lie. This mode lies in 30 to 40 interval. That means the class 30 to 40 is the model class. So what will be F1? F1 is the frequency of the model class. That means F1 is 16. Now F0 is frequency of the preceding class. That means X is F0. And F2 is the frequency of the succeeding class. That means F2 is equal to 12. Then what is L? L is the lower limit of the model class. H is the class size. Now we know mode is equal to L plus F1 minus F0 upon 2F1 minus F0 minus F2 into H. Just substitute all these values here. Mode is 36, L is 30, F1 is 16, F0 is X. Here 2 into F1 minus F0 minus F2 into 10. H is 10 here. Now this 10 is multiplied by this whole expression. But what will I do? 30 will be brought here. So we have 36 minus 30, which is 6, is equal to 16 minus X upon, this is 32 minus 12, that is equal to 20. 20 minus x into 10. Now 20 minus x will be multiplied by 6. We have 120 minus 6x is equal to 160 minus 10x. This implies minus 6x plus 10x is equal to 160 minus 120. Implies 4x is equal to 40. Implies x is equal to 10. Now we will learn about median, median of the grouped data. Median is given by the formula L plus n by 2 minus cumulative frequency upon F into H. Now what are all these? L is the lower limit of the median class. N is equal to the total number of observations. CF, it is the cumulative frequency of the class preceding the median class. F, it is the frequency of the median class. H is the class size. This example will explain this more beautifully. Find the median of the following distribution. Here we are given the marks and number of students. Range of the marks is 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70, 70 to 80, 80 to 90, and 90 to 100. Number of students who have got marks between 40 to 50 are 2. Here 3. Here 5. 70 to 80 are 7. 80 to 90 are 3. And 90 to 100 are 2. Right? Now look at all these terms that are included here and we will try to find them out. First thing is N. N, what does it mean? Total frequency. So we just add them. So N here comes out to be 22. Then I need cumulative frequency. So I will calculate the cumulative frequency. 2, 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 5, 10, 10 plus 7, 17, 17 plus 3 is 20, 20 plus 2 is 22. Now, n by 2, for median class, I need n by 2. N by 2 is equal to 22 upon 2, which is equal to 11. Now, we will look for the cumulative frequency, which is near 11 and just greater than 11. So, here, near 11, you are having 2, 10 and 17, but which is little greater, that is 17. Therefore, cumulative frequency is this. Therefore, the class which is having cumulative frequency little greater than n by 2 is called the median class. That means 70 to 80 is the median class. I repeat again, the class which has a cumulative frequency little greater than n by 2 is called the median class. Now, L was the lower limit of the median class. So, here L is 70. F is the frequency of the median class. So, F is equal to 7. H is the class size. Class size is 10. And when we have to put a cumulative frequency in the formula, we need cumulative frequency of the preceding class. So, cumulative frequency of the preceding median class is 10. So, CF will be taken as 10. Now, substitute all these in the formula. So, we get here median will be equal to 70, that is the lower limit, plus n by 2 is 11 minus CF upon 7 into 10, that is 70 plus 1 into 10 is 10 upon 7. This gives me 490 plus 10 upon 7, which implies 500 upon 7. That is equal to 71.4. Now, let us check. 71.4 when you are having, then let us check, does it lie in the median class? Yes. Our median class was 70 to 80. So, what does that mean? Our answer is correct, as it is lying between this. Now, let us revise all whatever we have done till now with the help of a question, that is, find mean, median and mode of the following data. So, this data is given, that is, class intervals vary from 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50 and 50 to 60. Frequency is 5, 7, 3, 4 and 1. First, we will find the mean. Mean is equal to sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. Mode L plus f1 minus f0 upon 2f1 minus f0 minus f2 into h. Median is equal to L plus n by 2 minus cf upon f into h. So first we are going to find out the mean using direct method. For this, I have created a table here in the vertical form and I will keep on finding whatever I require. So, first I need for median using this formula sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. I require xi and sigma fi and then fi xi. So, I extend my table to these two columns. Xi, as you know, it was the mid value of all these class intervals. So, here it is 15. Now, how to get all these Xi's? Just add the class size. 15 plus 10, 25. 25 plus 10, 35. 35 plus 10, 45. 45 plus 10, 55. Then we want Fi Xi. So, we are going to multiply all these columns. 5 into 15, 75. 7 into 25, 175, 3 into 35, 105, 4 into 45, 180, 1 into 55 is 55, right? And now sigma fi xi means sum of all these. The sum comes out to be 590 and also I require sigma fi. When you add it, you get it 20. So mean is equal to 590 upon 20, which is equal to 29.5. Now, let us see how to find the mean by assumed mean method. Mean is given by A plus sigma Fi Di upon sigma Fi. Now, a new term A and Di have come. What is A? A was the assumed mean. We used to take out assumed mean from Xi's. The middle one of the Xi's, the middle term of these Xi's is called A. I revise once again. If there are odd number of mid values, then we will have only one number in the center. But if they are even, then there will be two numbers in the center. In that case, you will take any one of them to be assumed mean. Then we want to calculate Di now. What is Di? Di is the deviation of the class mark from the assumed mean. So we find it as Xi minus A. So you subtract 15 from 35 from 15. What do you get? Minus 20. Next, these values how can you get? Again, you just add the class size. You will get the respective values here of Di. So this will be minus 10, 0, 10 and 20. Next, I want Fi Di. So Fi Di means Fi and Di. These columns are to be multiplied. So 5 into minus 20 is minus 100. 7 into minus 10 is minus 70. 3 into 0 is 0. 4 into 10 is 40. 1 into 20 is 20. In the formula, I require sigma. Sigma means sum. So sum is calculated. It comes out to be minus 110. So now sigma Fi is already calculated. So mean is equal to A, that is 35, plus minus 110 upon 20, that is equal to 30. This is equal to 0 and 0 will cancel. 2 into 35 is 70, minus 11 upon 2, that is 59 upon 2, which is 29.5. So we have verified also that the mean by both the formula is same. Now, how to get the mode? For mode, I want model class. How will I find the model class? Wherever the frequency is maximum. Here the frequency is maximum. So this is the model class. Here we can write. This is model class also. Alright. Then we want L. L is the lower limit. That is 20. You can see. Then F1. You have to calculate F1, F0, F2. Model class ki jo aapki hai frequency, that is going to be F1. Usse pehle wali F0 and this will be F2. And H is 10. Alright, so we substitute the values in the formula for mode. So L, that is 20 plus F1 minus F0. F1 is 7, F0 is 5. So 7 minus 5 upon 2 into F1, that is 2 into 7 minus F0 is 5 minus F2 is 3 into class size. So this is equal to 20 plus 2 upon 14 minus 8 into 10, that is equal to 20 plus 20 upon 6, which is 3.3. So 20 plus 3.3 is 23.3. Let's see whether our answer is correct. 23.3 lies between 20 to 30. That means my answer is correct. It is just an indication that your answer is correct. Okay. Now median. You know the formula for median. What was median? Median is equal to L plus N by 2 minus CF into H upon F. So we require, first we need to find out the median class. N by 2 is required. N by 2, how will I get? Sigma Fi upon 2 will give me that. That is 20 upon 2, which is 10. So my median class is going to be which one? Cumulative frequency, which is just greater than 10, is 12. So this class is the median class also. So 20 will be L. H is 10, F is the frequency of the median class, that is 7, CF will be the cumulative frequency of the preceding class, that is 5. Write them down and then put them all in the formula. So median will be equal to 20 plus 10 minus 5 n by 2 minus CF upon F, that is 7 into 10, which is equal to 20 plus, this will become 50 upon 7. That means 20 plus 7.1, which is equal to 27.1. And notice that 27.1 lies between 20 and 30. So this is an indication that our answer is correct. So dear students, what is the use of this video? The use of this simple video is that you go through the video or watch the video 2 times or maybe 3 times till all the concepts are clear to you. After that, you can solve this assignment, which will give you a good practice. And we'll have one more video in which we will take more questions on this topic. All these questions that I have taken in this assignment, they are also from the board papers. So this is a list of 10 questions which, if you practice sincerely, will help you a lot. Here one more concept was left. Let us do it quickly. Here there is a relation between these central tendencies. That is, 3 median is equal to mode plus 2 mean. Alright. And this relation is used for calculating the one of the central tendencies when 2 are given. Like, in a certain distribution, mean and median are 9.5 and 10 respectively. Find the mode of the distribution using this empirical formula. This formula is called empirical formula. Now here median and mean are given. So we can put these values over here and we can calculate the value of mode. Hope you will enjoy doing this exercise. Thank you.